Hey, Precal, let's solve some equations that use values that you would find on your unit circle. Remember on our memory test, I would ask you, what is the sine of pi over 4? And you'd give me an answer. What is the sine of 5 pi over 6? And you'd give me an answer. Well, what I'm going to give you today is kind of that answer. And you're going to give me what would give me the trig function. In this case, the sine that would give me this 1/2. Now, 1/2 positive would be angles that would be in this first quadrant or in the second quadrant. And in fact, a 30-degree angle is a sine of 1/2, so does a 30-degree angle over here. Okay, but we also have angles such as this that would also give the sine of to be 1/2. Okay, so here's how. There's three different ways I want you to present your answers, and here they are. So first of all, I know that x is a 30-degree angle. I want that in radians, please. And I know x is that 150-degree angle, which is 5 pi over 6. Now, those would be the answers within the first rotation between 0 up to 2 pi. And that's one answer that I want you to give me. Okay, another answer I want you to give me is I want you to give me an answer in general form. And general form means, well, what about those answers that are more than one revolution or backwards? And here's how we do that. We attach to this a counting mechanism. And since sine and cosine and secant and cosecant have a period of 2 pi, then our counting mechanism will be positive or negative, because you could go backwards. And then we'll say 2k, k being a counting variable, 2k pi. And then we'll do the same thing with the other one. X is equal to 5 over pi over 6, plus or minus that counting mechanism. And this is an answer in general form. And then what I would also like is for you to give me a generous list of solutions, 8 or so. And here's how we go about doing that. Well, pi over 6 would be the first one. 5 pi over 6 is the second one. And then I will get more solutions by adding 2 pi to the pi over 6 and the 5 pi over 6. And here's how I'll do that. So if I add 2 pi, now my noggin, I don't see 2 pi. I see 12 over 6 pi. Okay, so if I add 12 over 6 to my 1 pi, I get 13 pi over 6. If I add it to my 5 pi, I get 17 pi over 6. If I add another one to my 1 pi, I now get 25 pi over 6. If I add another one to my 5 pi, I now get 29 pi over 6. And there is a generous list of 6 solutions. And we could keep going. Add another one to the 1 pi. You would be up to 37 pi. Add another one to the 5 pi, and you'd be up to 41 pi over 6. And you could go on and on and on in days. Every one of these answers would have a sine equal to 1/2. Okay? Tangent of x is equal to a negative. Well, first of all, that would need to be in the second quadrant and the fourth quadrant here. And radical 3 over 3, you'll just have to look at your card or just play around with some values here. Now, I know it's not going to be a 45-degree angle, because the tangent of a 45-degree angle, whether it's here or down here or here or here, the tangent of a 45-degree angle is always 1. Okay? So is it the 30-degree angle? Let's see. As a point on the unit circle, this is a lot more over than it is up. So it is a negative radical 3 over 2 and a half. And tangent is the y on top of the x. And if I remove the 2's, but multiply top and bottom by 2, I get negative 1 over radical 3. And bingo, that would rationalize to that right there. So we have a winner. A 30-degree angle in the second quadrant, 30-degree angle in the fourth quadrant. Okay, so x is going to be 5 pi over 6, plus or minus. I'm going to go ahead and give the general form. Now, the period for tangent and cotangent is just a single pi. And so we'll have k pi. And then we also have, or in the fourth quadrant, That would be 11 pi over 6, plus or minus our k pi counting mechanism. So here's my answer in general form right here. That is general form. Okay, now a nice generous list of answers. So starting with my 5 pi over 6, now I'm going to add a k pi. I'm going to add 1 pi. Now instead of adding 1, since I'm dealing with 6's, I see it as 6 over 6 pi. So I'm going to add a 6 over 6, I'm up to 11 pi over 6. 11 pi over 6 is the second part. So since the 11 pi over 6 came from me working with this first part of the solution, I'm going to mark this out of the general form. So this first part is the only part of the solution that I need for general form. I'm going to keep adding 6 over 6 pi's. 17 over 6, 23, 29, and I could go on for days, 35, and on and on and on. And that is a nice, generous list of solutions. Now, which of these answers are within our interval from 0 to 2 pi? And that would be the 5 pi over 6 and the 11 pi over 6. So, three sets of answers, please. Let's do another. Secant of x is equal to radical 2. Don't really want to work with secant x, so I can quickly make this cosine x is equal to 1 over radical 2, and I can rationalize that to make that radical 2 over 2. So cosine of x is equal to positive. Well, first of all, that can only be here and here, and radical 2 over 2 is my 45 degree angle. Okay? So, general form, x will be pi over 4 plus or minus our counting mechanism. Cosine has a 2 pi period, so 2 k pi. And then the other one here is 7 pi plus or minus our counting mechanism. So there's my answer in general form. Now, how about a nice, generous list of answers? Okay, so here's a few coming from this one. Pi over 4, and then I'm going to add 2 pi's to that. But instead of 2 pi's, I see 8 fourths. Okay, so add 8 fourths, I get 9 over 4, 17 over 4, 25 over 4, and I could go on for days. Here, 7 pi over 4, and I want to add to it 2 pi's, but again, I'm seeing 8. Okay, so 7 pi over 4, 15, 23, and 31, and on and on and on and on. Now, which one of those answers are in the first rotation? And that would be pi over 4. I'm going to put these in order. 7 pi over 4. Let's see, 9 pi over 4 is 2 over 2 pi. So these would be the solutions within one interval. Okay? And one more. 5 cosecant x minus 3 is equal to the 2. We want to isolate our trig function here. Do that before we reciprocate. So I'm going to add my 3 over. And then I'm going to divide out the 5. And instead of working with cosecant, I would prefer to work with sine. And then I'll reciprocate the 1, and that's a 1 also. So sine is equal to 1. That's a quadrantal angle type answer. Is that over here, that point is 1, 0? Or is it up here, this point is 0, 1? Sine being the y value, it would be right here. So, and only there, because down here, it would be negative. So x is equal to pi over 2 only, plus or minus our counting mechanism. Okay, so a nice generous list of answers. In my noggin, the 2 pi becomes 4 over 2. So this is 5 pi over 2, 9 pi over 2, 13 pi over 2, 17 pi over 2. And I could go on and on and on. And the answers there that are within one rotation is only this first one, the pi over 2. So I want general form, a nice generous list of solutions, and then only those within this interval. Okay? Take care. Hug your folks. Yay, equations.